Now look at your map.
Purvanchal. I don't have a map here. What a physical map of Northeast India you will find. There are many small, small hills. Can you see? Miri, Abhor, Mishmi, Garo, Khasi. Okay? Can you see? So at least you should be familiar with what are the hills located there. Miri, Abhor, Mishmi, Patkaibam, Nagaland, okay? These are the small, small hills. Barren land. Okay. God, look at the map. देखो कौन कौन से बताओ. So boy, you start. Mention one hill in the northeast Purvanchal Himalayas. So that other Dafla Hills. Jatin, you say. Khasi Hills. Nisha, you say. Can you find any hills in the northeast India? Ning, what are the hills? पटकाए मेके आपको मिल रहा है. कैन यू सी इन द नॉर्थ ईस्ट इंडिया? हाँ, इन द मेघालय. गारो खासी जयंती मेघालय में है. एंड देर आर फ्यू हेयर इन द सीक्वेंस ओनली. इफ यू विल सी सीक्वेंस में आप देखोगे इंडिया के यहाँ पे तीन लगातार तीन चार रेंजेस आएंगे. नागा, मिजो, लुशाई हिल्स, दैट इज द मणिपुर हिल्स ओनली. ओके, मिजो. ओके, इज इट क्लियर? इज द इमेज क्लियर? इफ दिस नेम्स विल कम इन द न्यूज और एनी इवेंट दैट यू शुड बी फेमिलियर की वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट विच रीजन ऑफ द कंट्री. ओके, यू विल फाइंड टू पॉइंट्स. द हिमालयस आर लाइक दिस कन्वेक्स, राइट? हिमालयस, व्हाट इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ दिस? यू विल फाइंड टू इंपॉर्टेंट रेंजेस. Find out Namcha Barwa and Nanga Parvat here in the Jammu Kashmir region, Ladakh. Can you find? There is a, these are called the sharp bends. What happens? Himalaya bends sharply from here. Okay, these are the sharp two bends. Now we will write few points with respect to all the three major Himalayan ranges. Okay, first one you write heading the Great Himalayas or the Central Himalayas, or you can call Himadri. These are the loftiest mountains, right? सबसे ऊंचे होंगे. दूसरे ranges पे small वाले we will have हिमाद्री, हिमाचल, and then we will have small, much smaller ranges called Shivali. Three important ranges that we will study. ठीक है? First you write average elevation of 6,100 meter. Average elevation. ठीक है, एंड द एवरेज विथ इज अराउंड 25 किलोमीटर. इट इज मेनली फॉर्म्ड, दिस इज 25 किलोमीटर. ओके, इट इज मेनली फॉर्म्ड ऑफ द सेंट्रल क्रिस्टलाइन crystallines overlain. मतलब इसके ऊपर overlain by metamorphosed sediments, in bracket you write limestones. It is mainly formed of central crystallines. ठीक है, overlain by metamorphosed sediments, bracket limestones. Okay, basically the core is of granite and niches. उसके ऊपर से वी हैव सेडिमेंट्स ऑफ लाइमस्टोन, ओके, क्रिस्टलाइन, ग्रेनाइट एंड निशेस, टू टाइप्स ऑफ दिस रॉक्स टाइप रॉक्स आर देयर, ग्रेनाइट एंड निशेस, ये क्रिस्टलाइन रॉक्स में आ जाती है, ओके, ग्रेनाइट्स एंड GNEISS ओवरलेन बाय, मतलब इसके ऊपर सेडिमेंट्स किसके हैं, वी हैव सेडिमेंट्स ऑफ लाइमस्टोन, ओके, the folds in this range, the folds in this range are asymmetrical, the folds in this range are asymmetrical with steep south slope, steep south slope and gentle north slope, gentle north slope, giving it a hogback topography. Gentle in the north, okay? Means the steep slope from the southern. Suppose this is the Indian northern place, the slope is very steep, okay? So it is very difficult to climb from the Indian side, okay? North is the south ki sides, okay? Gentle in the northern side. With the Tibet, from the Tibet side, it is gentle slope. Getting? So it is easy to climb the Everest from the Tibetan side or the Chinese side. The slope with respect to the Indian side is very steep. Matlab, idam straight as a slope hai. Getting what is the meaning? And a special type of topography that is called, this feature that they are forming, that are called hogback topography. Okay? Next one you write, the middle or the lesser Himalayas. Achha, what are the few important mountain ranges that you can find in this? Mount Everest is in this only, okay? In this range only. Mount Everest, Kanchenjunga. Look in your map, find out what are the important ranges in this main range. Mount Everest, Namcha Barwa is there. Kanchenjunga is there. Kamet Parvat is there in India. Can you find these three ranges? Kanchenjunga, can you find where it is? Near Sikkim? Mount Everest, Namcha Barwa, Kanchenjunga. Right, the ice mountain. It is covered with ice, yes. The top. K2, it will have ice. Dry ice. Yes, it is cold, na, so it is dry region. Wherever there is severe cold, it is also considered the third pole. Himalayas are considered third pole, right? Because after North Pole and South Pole, maximum ice sheets are present in the Himalayas only, okay? So it is the top of the Himalayas is very cold, covered with the glaciers and ice. And it is a dry region. Wherever there is a heavy or felt dry air, okay? So dry region it is. Now write middle or the lesser Himalayas, Himachal. Elevation of around 3500 meters, okay? to 80 kilometers of the width. So can you see it is more wider at the bottom compared to this greater Himalayas. This is having thin, this is less, this is around 25 to 30 kilometers width only, this is 60 to 80 kilometers. It is in between the Shivaliks and the greater Himalayas. Where it is located? In between the Shivaliks and the greater Himalayas. Next point, runs almost parallel to both the ranges. runs almost parallel to both the ranges. ठीक है. Lower Himalayas have steep bare southern slope. Steep bare मतलब खाली, bare southern slopes and gentle and more gentle and more gentle forest covered northern slopes. Here you write, this is a continuous, a little bit compared to others, it is a continuous range. Here you can write one word, these Himalayas are continuous. ठीक है, हाँ continuous. It means they are like ranges, they are sims like this, continuous ranges. Here they have breaks. ठीक है, these are discontinuous. These are continuous and they are discontinuous ranges. Okay. Examples you can find Pir Panjal, Dholadhar. Last line have you completed forest covered northern slopes. Okay. Next examples you write Pir Panjal ranges. Pir Panjal, Dholadhar, Kumaon ranges. Next time you write, in Uttarakhand, middle Himalayas are marked by, जो मसूरी, मसूरी is the part of this middle Himalayas only. It's marked by मसूरी and the Nag Tibba ranges. Nag Tibba ranges. Find, अब देखो पीर पंजाल, देखो मैप में, look into the map and find the पीर पंजाल. Found धौलाधर. ठीक है, अच्छा also remember one more, there is near to Himalayas there is one more range, कैलाश range also you find. Okay. Here you will find one range called कैलाश range. Okay. So that also you mark here near this range, near the Uttarakhand border. यहाँ पे you will find one कैलाश ranges. Okay. Sometimes it comes or sometimes not. कैलाश ranges. Okay. Yeah. हाँ. They are behind the greater Himalayas. Okay. This region. कैलाश ranges. Next, Shivalik ranges. They are also known as Outer Himalayas. ठीक है, और क्या कहते, अभी लिखवाया था ना, क्या क्या कहते, what were the names? शिवालिक लिखा था, लोअर ही तो बोल, लोअर फॉर द मिडिल हिमालयस शिवालिक ही कहते हैं एंड आउटर हिमालयस और एनीथिंग एल्स. चलो राइट, लोकेटेड इन बिटवीन द ग्रेट प्लेन्स एंड लेसर हिमालयस. What is below them? If you will be asked, what is below them after Shivaliks? What we have? Those are in Shivalik. This is below Shivaliks. We have Great Plains or Great Northern Plains, you can say. ठीक है, located between the Great Plains and the Lesser Himalayas. ठीक है, altitude varies from 600 to 1500 meters. Altitude is approximately 600 to 1500 meters. This shows how elevated they are. This is around 6,000 kilometers. This is around 3,500 kilometers in the height. And this is around 600 to 1,500 only, 1,000 kilometers height. With you, right? Next. Around that, they are around 80. Width is around 80 kilometers. 50 to 80 kilometers width, you can write. हाँ विथ इतनी थी लगभग 60 टू 80 लगभग ठीक है सेम विथ लगभग दे आर मोर लेस अराउंड 50 ओनली ओके एवरेज इज अराउंड 50 रिमेंबर दिस 50 नंबर यू रिमेंबर एवरेज विथ इज 50 नेक्स्ट पॉइंट रन्स फॉर अ डिस्टेंस ऑफ 2400 किलोमीटर्स runs for a distance of 2400 from the Potwar plateau this is in Pakistan Potwar plateau theek hai from the Potwar plateau to the Brahmaputra valley From the Potwar plateau runs for a distance of around 2400 kilometers from the Potwar plateau that is in Punjab of Pakistan and to the Brahmaputra valley okay this ranges also have they have steep southern slope the southern slopes are steep while the northern slopes are gentle They are almost, next point you write, they are almost unbroken chain of, they are almost unbroken chain of low hills, they are almost unbroken chain of low hills except for a gap of 80 to 90 kilometers. Except for a gap of 80 to 90 kilometers, which is occupied by the valley of Teesta River and Raidak River. Teesta and Raidak, R-A-I-D-A-K. Tista, T-I-S-T-A. It runs from India to it goes into the West Bengal, okay, Bangladesh. So average width is around, if this is a Shivalik ranges, so here its width is around 50 kilometers, okay, and it goes on reducing. In Arunachal Pradesh, it is around just 15 kilometers width, okay. So it is wider near the western region, western part of the India, and goes on decreasing towards the eastern margins, okay. Written. Now, what is the regional division of Himalayas? Suppose this is the Himalaya, right? This is from west to east. Okay. Region wise, it is how it is divided. It is divided on the basis of the rivers flowing around it. Okay. So, which is the important river that is flowing here? If you can recall any important river, this is the Indus. Okay. What is the second river next to Indus? Satluj is there. Jhelum is there, but that is Satluj demarcates it. Okay. Second one is Satluj River. Third one, important river in this line, if you can see any international river that is flowing. Can you see? Kali River. Nepal, near Nepal region. Kumaon Nepal border. There is Uttarakhand. There is a Uttarakhand and Nepal. There is a Kali River. ठीक है. Then we have Tista. And at the last, what we have here? Which is this river? This is Brahmaputra. Okay. This, the region between Indus and Satluj is called Punjab Himalayas. The region between Indus and Satluj River is called the Punjab Himalayas. Then we have Kumaon. Kumaon is located in Uttarakhand, okay? So Uttarakhand and Nepal ke beech mein we have Kali River. And this is the Nepal Himalayas. Here we have Nepal. This is the region wise division of Himalayas. Okay, longitudinally we have seen how parallel wise we have seen north to south, how they are bifurcated in the ranges. This is region wise. On the basis of the flowing rivers, they have divided the Himalayas in these regions. Okay, and what will be the last one? Here we have Assam, right? Tista River is flowing Assam. Can you see these rivers also there in the physical map of India? Can you see? Near Sikkim, Darjeeling, West Bengal and Bangladesh region. Tista River. It is there in the map. Look in the map and you find out where it is located, this Tista. Can you find all the rivers in the physical map? So let's recall what we have done today, okay? How we started the class? Sobo, how we started the class? What was the topic we started with? Let's first recall once, because recalling is important, then only you will remember tomorrow also. What we did first in the class? What is the latitudinal extent? Anyone can tell? Longitudinal and latitudinal extent of India? In the north and south. Which, acha, you name the points. Southernmost point and the northernmost point. Which was the southernmost point in the mainland India? Kanyakumari. That is called Cape Camorin. And in north? Okay. Next, what we did? Okay. The Indra Col. In the west we had Kutch, okay? And in the east we had the Kibutu region, okay? This is next what we did, what was the important map? How many countries? India is surrounded by how many countries? International countries? 8 or 9? 7 countries and 2 island nations also, right? 7 countries, which is Pakistan, China, Nepal, Bhutan, Myanmar, Bangladesh, okay? Then Maldives and Sri Lanka, okay? Which country has longest boundary with India? Bangladesh, okay? Next, what we did? After that, what we did? Is it tropical temperature? Is that reason clear? Then what were the Tropic of Cancer passes through how many how many states? Karuna. Okay. Okay. Tripura, okay. Remaining, you tell Nisha. Jharkhand was there. Okay. Then we studied about next tropical or temperate. Then what are the physiographic divisions? Major physiographic divisions. Nisha, you tell. What are the important physiographic divisions of India? Himalayas. We looked at the formation of Himalayas and all. Okay. So revise it and come. Tell me what are the physiographic divisions once. Trans Himalayas are part of physiographic divisions, no? What are the major physiographic divisions of India? Kaun kaun se we did? Ek minute, Jatin, I'm asking to her. Tell Nisha. We did physiographic divisions, kaun se the, tell. What are the physiographic divisions? Speak it up, say it. ये बताया था स्पीक फर्स्ट वन सेकेंड ओके नेक्स्ट ओके डेजर्ट ओके सो यू विल रिमेम्बर व्हाट आर द फिजियोग्राफिक मेजर फिजियोग्राफिक डिविजन्स ऑफ इंडिया ओके दीज सिक्स आर द मेजर फिजियोग्राफिक डिविजन्स डाइवर्सिटी देन वी स्टार्टेड विद द हिमालयस ओके सो यू डू द रिविजन एंड रीड द बुक्स ओके जरूर रीड जरूर बुक करो ओके बुक को रीड करो तभी ज्यादा बेटर अंडरस्टैंडिंग होगी ओके डोंट स्टडी इन द एयर की हवा में क्लास हो गई खत्म हो गया बस इसको अच्छे से प्रिपेयर करो इफ यू आर स्टडिंग इट स्टडी इट थरोली चलो थैंक यू क्लास वी विल एंड इट हियर